guys and girls, welcome to the fourth Wiki Wednesday Whispers. This week is going to be by request. I will be talking about the Tesla coil or Tesla coils. Since I guess there's not like a Tesla coil. So it's kind of a long article, so I don't know if I'm going to get through the whole thing or not. See what happens and kind of play it by ear. Kind of like right now I'm whispering in your right ear. Just gonna put that on the floor. So my roommate's not home right now, so I can finally make a video. I am still gonna make the unbagging video. I want to call it an unboxing, but it's not really an unboxing. It's an unbagging video that I talked about in my quick update video. So that is coming. I might even make it tonight. I'm not sure yet. We'll see how long this one takes. And I know that there have been some requests for ear-to-ear whispering and some scratching sounds as well. So I might... might do that when I do the unbagging video. But without further ado, let's get started. Tesla coil. A Tesla coil is an electrical resonant transformer circuit invented by Nikola Tesla around 1891. It is used to produce high voltage, low current, high frequency alternating current electricity. Tesla coils can produce higher voltages than electrostatic machines, which are another source of artificial high voltage discharges. Tesla experimented with a number of different configurations consisting of two or sometimes three coupled resonant electric circuits. Tesla used these coils to conduct innovative experiments in electrical lighting, phosphorescence, X-ray generation, high-frequency alternating current phenomena, electrotherapy, and the transmission of electrical energy without wires. Tesla coil circuits were used commercially in spark gap radio transmitters for wireless telegraphy until the 1920s, and in medical equipment such as electrotherapy and violet ray devices. Today, their main use is for entertainment and educational displays, although small coils are used as leak detectors for high vacuum systems. It's kind of cool. Sorry, that was kind of loud. Subsection 1. Operates in a significantly different fashion from a conventional transformer. In a conventional transformer, the windings are very tightly coupled, and voltage gain is determined by the ratio of the number of turns in the winding. This works well at normal voltages, but at high voltages, the insulation between the two sets of windings is easily broken down, and this prevents iron core transformers from running at extremely high voltages without damage. Unlike those of a conventional transformer, which may couple 97% or more of the fields between windings, a Tesla coil's windings are loosely coupled with a large air gap, and thus the primary and secondary typically share only 10 to 20% of their respective magnetic fields. Instead of a tight coupling, the coil transfers energy via loose coupling from one oscillating resonant circuit, the primary, to the other, the secondary, over a number of radio frequency cycles. As the primary secondary. The secondary's output voltage increases until all of the available primary energy has been transferred to the secondary. Less losses. Even with significant spark gap losses, a well-designed Tesla coil can transfer over 85% of the energy initially stored in the primary capacitor to the secondary circuit. The high voltage, the voltage achievable from a Tesla coil can be significantly greater than a conventional transformer because the secondary winding is a long single layer solenoid widely separated from the surroundings and therefore well insulated. Although the voltage per turn in any coil is higher because the rate of change of magnetic flux is at high frequencies, with the loose coupling, the voltage gain is instead proportional to the square root of the ratio of secondary and primary inductances. Because the secondary winding is wound to be resonant at the same frequency as the primary, this voltage gain is proportional to the square root of the ratio of the primary capacitor to the stray capacitance of the secondary. Oh boy. That's the end of subsection 1, theory. Hopefully it will be a little bit less technical jargony now. I hope. As I said, it is a pretty long article, so I don't think I'm going to read the whole thing. But yeah, so subsection 2, history. The Tesla coil transformer implanted a capacitor which, upon breakdown of a short spark gap, became connected to a coil of a few turns, forming a resonant circuit with the frequency of oscillation, usually 20 to 100 kHz, determined by the capacitance of the capacitor and the inductance of the coil. The capacitor was charged to the voltage necessary to rupture the air of the gap, about 10 kV, by a line power transformer connected across the gap. The line transformer could tolerate the short circuit occurring while the gap remained ionized, or for the few milliseconds until the high frequency current had died away. Excuse me. A more prominent secondary winding with vastly more turns of thinner wire than the primary was positioned to intercept some of the magnetic field of the primary. The secondary was designed to have the same frequency of resonance as the primary, using only the straight capacitance of the winding itself and that of any top hat placed at the upper end. The later high-power coil design has a single-layer primary and secondary. These Tesla coils are often used by hobbyists and at venues such as science museums to produce large, long sparks. The American electrician gives a description of an early Tesla coil, wherein a glass battery jar, 15 by 20 centimeters or 6 by 8 inches, is wound with 60 to 80 turns of AWG number 18 B and S magnetic wire. No idea what that is. 0.823 millimeters squared, that'd be the cross-sectional area of the wire, I believe. Into this is slipped a primary consisting of 8 turns to 10 turns, 8 to 10 turns of AWG number 6 P and S wire, 13.3 millimeters squared. And the whole combination is immersed in a vessel containing linseed or mineral oil. 1902 design, subsection 3. Tesla's 1902 design for his advanced magnifying transmitter used a top terminal consisting of a metal frame in the shape of a design allowed the terminal to support very high voltages without generating cornea or sparks. Tesla, during his patent application process, described a variety of resonator terminals at the top of his later coil. Enjoy the technical stuff, but I think I am going to not do too much of it tonight. I think I'm actually going to stop there for right now, because it's a lot of very technical kind of stuff. Really do want to hear that, let me know, and I will make another video finishing the rest of this article if there is a large surprise.